all that we think that our father are the lucky ones, but we know who the real lucky ones are, and that's us. Because we thank the Lord that each one of us is here tonight so that we get to celebrate a part of their lives. Father and Father, you have shown us a tradition of love and of family first, a tradition that began many years ago with Grandma Pop, Grandma Betsy and Papa, their parents. You have truly been a blessing to us as you inspire, motivate, and encourage. I know that Claudia and I can't thank you enough for being the most fantastic parents anyone could ever ask for. You've helped us to know that life is an amazing journey full of great adventures. You have always supported us in what we chose to do and given us opportunities of a lifetime. It is our hope that we can pass on the values you have instilled in us to the lives that we touch. There are so many memories over the years that we will always cherish. We always had the coolest toys to play with, and many of you know that, especially Beth and Ray. When they would come over to play, we always had these wonderful Flintstone blocks, and we thought they were the greatest things in the whole wide world. And then there's a locker in the Malone plan that we couldn't live without, and too bad not all of them got to experience our wonderful roller coaster in the backyard. But we had a great pool, and that great pool is too bad it's still not here because it was wonderful. You helped us to grow our talents. Many people still think that I am a music teacher and a computer teacher. And I'm sure that many people can't believe that Claudia's not on the tennis circuit right now. Of course, I failed in that department. We've had fabulous vacations over the years. We've always had like one of our fun experiences. I can remember going to Disney, and we were one of the first families to be at the Contemporary, and we got these cool, nifty little cards, and they were charge cards. And at that time, in the 1970s, a kid having a charge card was unheard of. So you thought you just owned the place. It was fabulous. It was worth nothing, but it was really neat. From there, we've done many cruises together. We've always gone to the beach and to Florida. And Father had a wonderful experience in the hot tub, which I might tell you about later. He almost drowned in the hot tub. It's a great story. You'll have to tell to me. He lost his glasses in this hot tub, and he started screaming to people, "Help, help me, I'm drowning, I'm drowning." And no one would believe it because he was in 3 feet of water. Why no one would help him get up. And he came to us all sobbing, but he said, "I was drowned in there." And he still couldn't find his glasses. We felt bad for him. And you've always given us unbelievable opportunities. I can remember, Mother, that you gave us the trip of a lifetime when I know that you would have wanted to go. And eventually you got there, but I know you gave us that. You've allowed us to blossom and to grow in ways that we wanted to grow and to do things we wanted to do. You let me go to University of South Florida, I have no idea why I went there. And the next day I turned around and decided that was not the place for me, and they shipped everything back. And there aren't many families or parents on the base there that still, you know, say, "Come on home, Jane, it's okay." So, and from then I went to Berkeley, and everything just went from there, so it was great. So most of all, we'd like to thank you for taking the time and for sharing you with us, because we are very fortunate. When I know on a daily basis what some students face, we are incredibly lucky to have parents who spent time with us and who did things with us and who cared about us, about our education, about what we did, about our choices, and about just even going to church. And there aren't many, many families that care about that, and we thank them for that. And I'm happy that most of you are the same, all of you are the same. So thank you for being wonderful relatives also and friends. Mother and Father, tonight we wish you a very happy 50th anniversary. We wish for you and for all of us the opportunity to celebrate many more of these occasions. We love you, we respect you, we admire you. Most of all, we appreciate you and all you do for us. Did we say that we love you? Well, we do, you know that big time. I'd like to take a moment and introduce the head table. This is the wedding party, but as you know, there are several people that couldn't. Well, there are two people who are deceased, and that's Dr. Letha Barber and Mr. Digger Claypool. And Marilyn Kearns is in Seattle, and she could not be here, but she did send some flowers back there, so we miss her greatly. But we got Uncle Bob and Joni Kristen, and Wayne and Carol Malone, and Jim and Aaron Scott, and Bob and Nancy Boyer, and Dawn Brady. So thank you all for being here, for being a very, he was a cellist, it's being a very special part in their wedding. Thank you, thank you. Right now I'm going to ask the Reverend Marvin Watson to come on up and give the toast if he would like to. Or are you the one and only person? You the one person? You don't have the toast? Yeah, I was going to let him do the invocation after that. Do the toast, there the, might as well.
John talked to me about doing this. He stressed the importance of non-alcoholic toast. So I think that's what it is. My wife and I, he's like a member over there, her name is Ann, want to wish Nancy and John best wishes, congratulations. And we deeply appreciate the opportunity of being here with friends and family. I got to know John by playing in the Stringer Band, Jerry Temple Band. And we would go to rehearsals together. One night, Joe said, John is not with us. I said, well, where is he? He said he went to a card party. So, being a quick guy, I thought the next time I see him, I'm going to get in my cards. And I said to John, now if I had a choice between playing an instrument and going to a card party, that wouldn't be a hard decision for me to make. And John said, well, I hear what you're saying. But there's more to it than just that. He said, I have a date with my wife to go to that card party, and that's important for us to be together, and he stressed the importance of the love that he had for his wife. And my response was, I hear what you're saying, and I don't have any issue with that. There's no argument. So we deeply appreciate Nancy and John, and having been a part of our lives for some 9 years. And it is my pleasure to offer a toast in honor of Nancy and John.
John and Nancy, that you give them another 50 years, Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
While we're waiting, because it looks like, right? I don't know where the white stuff is, but I think they're ready for us. While we do that, Claudia, I'm going to ask you to please go back and check to see if they're ready for us. It's like